Better late than never? Goosebumps.
Based off of the book,
the famous book series called Goosebumps. But isn't it good? So, this will be a brief summary. Spoiler. Goosebumps start off a movie as the main character, Snack, moves into, his new home in Detroit. Now, but in Detroit, he finds out, okay, sorry, that was my sister, if you guys could hear that, noise. So he finds, this girl named Hannah, who is, he finds R.L. Stein, but he doesn't know that that's R.L. Stein. By this time, he already knows what the Goosebumps are. So, he meets the man. He meets the man, R.L. Stein, and he says, don't go over the gate. Then his daughter, Hannah, after a brief school, and now his mother is the vice principal, she sneaks up on him at a gate. They go to this shut down amusement park. And then they bond a little friendship. I'm pretty sure. And then after that, Mr. R.L. Stein, played as Jack Black, finds out what they were doing, and he pretty much just mad about it. And after that, it looks like he's giving Hannah a scolding, which is pretty bad. Hold on. Okay, new me. So he called the 911 on them. And after that, it turns out that he was innocent. They were also hanging out. I'm pretty sure after that, another school day. Also, he made friends with a kid named Chin. After he sees another scolding, from Hannah, he goes to sneak into that place by himself. And while that's happening, is the school dance. At the school, during the school dance, he calls up a friend, Champ, and, after that, they go through all his booby traps, and, his bear traps, and, after they go through that, they open up one of his Goosebumps books. After that, a frost snow giant. They quickly follow him to an ice skating rink, where they trap him in the book again. After that, what happens? What happened after that is that, Hannah was with them at that time. And then, Orloff Stein found out again, and then they find out that he is Orloff Stein, finally. And then, straight after that, they look at the floor, and there's the book of Slappy. Slappy is the main villain in this movie. And surprise, he tells the story about why he made Goosebumps. And it was just to terrorize the neighborhood kids. And after that, Slappy's there, and then, what he does is he just, he goes near the book, and he's just like, "You're trying to put me in the book again." And he's like, "No, no, no." And then he unleashes all of the book. And now it's Hunt. And, what happens is they go to the school dance. And, just dancing, and then, Earl Stein explains that he has to go to the, actually, before all that happens, there's like a cockroach, and they go to, grocery store, and then, his aunt, who was helping him, packing in, just runs over the cockroach. And then after that, they both fall in love, Orloff Stein and the aunt. Oh, also, I know I'm skipping most of their parts, but in the beginning, it's revealed that, Zach's dad is dead. Or, what's he? And that's why I don't like it. One of the reasons I don't like it. So, after that, what happens is, he tells them, the plan. He has to go to the school to get his typewriter and make a book, Goosebumps book, to capture all the people. He does that, and then, Zach, Hannah, and Cham are on their way, and they go to the dance, and then they're just telling the students, like, there's monsters invading the world, and then, there's this guy who made fun of them once, and then he made fun of them the second time, and then just like, "No, really," and then, everybody believed them. After that, what happened is, this guy and a girl are just like, "We should be helping, we shouldn't be helping," and then him and, he retreats when, there's a werewolf, coming, and then Champ, saves him, and then they share a kiss, and then they also share a hug. After that, what happens is that Orloff Stein gives the book, first of all, they evacuate with Orloff Stein. But before that happens, the moon shines at Hannah, and then Champ is just like, "She's a," and Mac is just like, "I know, I don't care." And that's the one line that I love. And after that, what happens after that is that they go far off time, and they go to the abandoned Amusement Park once again. And then, Arlstein gives them the book. And then he gets, swallowed by the blob that ate everyone. And, Zack finishes the book, and then, he finds out, if I do this, then the book will suck up Hannah also. And then she's just like, no, I can't let this happen. She's sacrificing herself. And then he's trying to hold her for a long time until she just gives up. And then they share a kiss, Hannah and Zack. And then we see everybody tears up as she fades away. With all the other Goosebumps. And another one of my favorite quotes is like when Slappy is about to fight him, and he's like, Slappy is my friend, and he's like, and Stein is needed. He throws him into the book, and then what happens after that is that they're all sad. Zack and Arlstein mostly. After that, what he does is they jumpstart to that Jack Black and Arlstein is now with the cute teacher. Because of the earlier event. So he's not a substitute. And then, and turns out that Zack and Arlstein are pretty close now. Yeah, at the end of school, it's just like, Zack is just like, do you miss her? And he's like, there's not a day goes by that I miss her. And then, another funny thing is that there was a guy named Mr. Black, which just made me laugh because it was, he's Jack Black. And then he goes like, I wrote another Goosebumps book. And he turns to see that Hannah is back, and he lights the other book on fire. So then they share a kiss, and then pretty much just they go walk out, and then he looks at while Jack Black is looking through the trophies and everything, there's a typewriter. Specifically his typewriter. And you see that. And that the Invisible Boy is still alive, and he was just like the Invisible Boy's revenge. And then after that, it's just Arlstein fake illness. And then it's just writing into a Goosebumps book. And that was my Goosebumps review. Did you like it? Did you not like it? But, overall, I wish they would have gone through the Snack Dad story way more often. No. For the rest of the part, it was actually a good movie. Oh, I forgot to tell you guys about the nose. Just watch it on Netflix. Nobody can watch it like that. But, on a scale from 1 to 10, I'll give it a 9. Just because I thought the Snack Dad story could have had way more potential. He could have been a goofball. That would have been an amazing story. But, it was kinda short. But I feel like if they did dumb with Jack, I mean, that dad for it, then that would be way better. Now for the next time, this is your helpless penguin. And penguin, I'm out.